Hi, we are a group of students from Antonio Machado School. A few weeks ago, we were on a trip and we visited some Spanish cities, which were Ávila, Segovia, and Salamanca. Now, we are going to talk about these beautiful places.
Hello, we are in Salamanca. This is our first day of our trip to Segovia, Ávila, Salamanca.
Salamanca is one of the most beautiful cities in Spain. It was declared an historical city by UNESCO in 1988 because of her monuments and her university that is the oldest in Spain.
And 1756. It's Baroque and the architect is Alberto Churriguera. It's not perfect, it's irregular, and any of the space are measured the same. In that square is the town hall, and people come here to enjoy and visit the square.
Era italiano, ¿no? Pues ahora.
In Plateresco style.
And it was built in 1483 and finished in 1517.
The facade sticks out because it's decorated with more than 300 shells.
And the legend says that in one of those shells there is a gold coin.
Salamanca, and this is the new cathedral. The new cathedral was constructed between the 16th and 18th century, but with two styles, the late Gothic and the Baroque, and it was built because the old cathedral wasn't bigger enough.
It's one of two cathedrals in Salamanca. It's completed in Romance and Gothic style in 14th century. It's dedicated to Santa Maria de la Sede.
This is the first university in Spain and the fourth one in Europe. It belongs to the 12th century and it has just pulled off to get 30,000 students at it.
The university wall is in Plateresco style, and inside it you can visit where Fray Luis de León used to study.
We are in the garden of Calisto and Melibea, which are two characters from a play written by Fernando de Rojas. This play is called La Celestina, known as La Tragicomedia de Calisto y Melibea.
Good morning. We have arrived to Ávila. Ávila is the highest capital from Spain, with more than 100 meters. You can see the medieval walls that are made by the Romans.
We are here in Ávila, where Santa Teresa was born in 1550. Here we have the monastery of San Jose, where she lived for 30 years. The monastery of San Jose was the first foundation. She was a mystic writer.
Now I'm going to read a poem of Santa Teresa de Jesús. Nada te turbe, nada te espante, todo se pasa, Dios no se muda. La paciencia todo lo alcanza, quien a Dios tiene nada le falta.
San Juan de la Cruz is another mystery writer, and I'm going to read a poem. En una noche oscura, con ansias, en amores inflamada, oh dichosa aventura, salí sin ser notada, estando ya mi casa sosegada. A oscuras y segura, por la secreta escala disfrazada, oh dichosa aventura, a oscuras y encerada, estando ya mi casa sosegada. En la noche dichosa, en secreto, que nadie me veía, ni yo miraba cosas, sin otra luz y guía, sino la que en el corazón ardía.
We are in Segovia, and we are going to see the Aqueduct of Segovia. It was built by the Romans in the first century after Christ, and it was used to transport water.
The legend says that a young girl had to go every day to get water, and one day a man appeared. He said her that he did a good ability to transport the water. She accepted, but he must do it before the sun rises up, and he accepted. If they could be, she had to give her soul. In the night, she saw the man in the middle of the fair and around some demons. They went to call the last fish, but the sun started to rise up and they couldn't.
We have enjoyed the time we have spent there. They were two interesting cities. You are invited to visit them. We hope you like this video. Adios, goodbye.